I'm Lucy Hawking, and I'm absolutely delighted that my father, Stephen Hawking's collection, is coming here to the Science Museum Group. It's an amazing collection of all the objects and the paperwork and the books and the artifacts that were in his office in Cambridge. So it's really an opportunity actually to experience his working environment as it was. My father loved the Science Museum. His parents would bring him here when he was a small boy, and so he'd spend all day here kind of immersed in the wonder of scientific discovery. I actually think he'd be a little bit overwhelmed if he realised that he was here and that he wasn't, that among all the people that the scientists that he'd looked up to in his life, you know, he really believed in the standing on the shoulders of giants thing. I think he'd be really sort of overwhelmed with joy and emotion to realise he was now one of the giants. There's a very beautiful portrait here painted of my father by the artist Fred Cummings. My father really liked this portrait. He has this lovely amused, sort of wry look on his face. It does portray him as a person with a disability, but it also shows him as a person. So I think that's why he liked it so much. So there's a series of bets here that my father made with John Preskill and Kip Thorne. And I think these are really telling because they speak to his sense of confidence in himself and his work. So I just love that. He wasn't afraid of being wrong. He wasn't afraid of admitting he'd made a mistake, but he was perfectly happy to take a punt on the fact that he thought he was probably right. I love seeing his spectacles. They're so cute. They're tortoiseshell. I can just sort of imagine him wearing them. Also, they tell a story because there's a sensor on the side of them, and that sensor actually connects with the screen, and that allowed him to communicate because that's how he operated his assisted communication system. And so, in fact, it's a sort of really important thing to take note of because this is part of the history of the development of technology, the history of how people with disabilities have been able to use technology to facilitate what they needed to do. So it's sort of both emotional and very meaningful at the same time.